Welcome back to Virtual Reality. My name is Thomas and you're watching Voodoo DVR. Finally, the long-awaited test and review of the Pimax 8KX is here. I had a lot of time to try this headset and I will show you all the different points, the pros and contras. I will tell you about the display, the lenses, the field of view, the comfort, weight, cable length and all the stuff. And after that, I will give you a conclusion and the price and if it's worth it. So, yeah, you can find everything about VR and AR on this channel thanks to my sponsors Woodghost VR, Open Events, Peter Wasmeyer, Andy DeFelzer, VR Ambassador, Virtual Escape and Adams Group. Let's have some fun with the video and let's go! Voodoo.de. So as always, let's talk about the design first. As you can see, not much changed. You've seen all the VR headsets from Pimax here. They look all the same. Only thing, the front, the V is changed, the color changed. This one is silver. The other ones is green or blue. For me, I personally like the green one most. But it depends on you. Then they have another design here. It's rubber material here. They call it ruggedized edition. And that's really cool, I must say. It's really, it feels not so cheap like the old Pimax headsets. That feels like cheap plastics. Also the gaps here are, it looks better. They really did a good thing here. It doesn't look as cheap as before, I must say. And however, I cannot tell you how that looks in 6 months or whatever. Also, this is not my Pimax, so I cannot throw it against the wall so that that I can try if it breaks. It doesn't feel like it breaks directly, but I think it's fine. So also the head strap here, it looks really good. It doesn't look cheap. There is a Pimax engraved here. And also the head strap, it looks really stylish. It looks like a cool headset. It looks like a worthy headset, like an expensive headset, I would say. But of course, it depends on you. Also here, the face gasket is very big. It looks very huge. And also, I love the color here, the gray color of the foam. Yeah, guys, so this is the design. For me, it's great. I love the Pimax design, but of course, this is not really the most important part. Let's talk about comfort, weight, and cable length. So let's start with the negative one. The cable is too short. I already noticed that when I from my first impressions video where I played Medal of Honor and I couldn't get to the other side of my play area. With most other headsets, I can get to the other side of my play area. And this cable is only a little bit more than 4 meters. Here is already the end. So it's, for me, it's too short and I cannot agree with the decision. All the other headsets from Pimax had longer cables. So why didn't they just use a longer cable? It's not bad. It's very bad. So yeah, this is a really negative point. There could be some extension cables. Here I want to ask the community if you already tested an extension cable for USB and DisplayPort successfully with the Pimax 8KX, then please write it in the comments and I will put the link in the description as soon as there are some successfully tested extension cables. So this is a negative point. The next one is the weight. It's 942 grams. And for me, that's a little bit too much. It's more than usual, but I mean, look, this, it's a big thing. It has big lenses. It of course is a little bit heavier, but however, when we wear it, I will show you how to wear it. Just put it up, then use the screw here, put it on your face, then remove the strap here, put it down like until the end here, then use the screw to tighten it, and then use the strap here to fix it like that. And now I must say this headset is, I mean, it's heavy, but it's really comfortable. It's with this SD mass, as they call this strap. It's really comfortable. I don't feel any problems here or where something pushes on my head or whatever. It's great. It's just cool. And the only thing, but it depends on your head shape, I can see light through the sides here. So behind me is a light on the wall, and I can see it reflecting on the lenses through the sides here. So if you have the problem, just use some stuff here to fill the holes here. I mean, they are for getting air into the sides here, but if you don't like that, you can just glue something here or whatever. And if I hold my fingers here, it's totally dark. Even from the bottom on the nose, there's no light leakage. So yeah, for me the comfort is very good, but of course it depends on your head shape. It's strange. all in all, the comfort is great, but the cable for me with a little bit over 4 meters is too short. Okay, and now let's check out the setup, and this is really important. The Pi tool is very mighty, and so what can you do here? So at first, you download the newest Pi tool from the PiMax page. This is an exe file, and then you just double click and go on, and then okay. And then you will get this tool here. So insert display port and insert the two USB ports. And if you see this here, then it should be fine. It could be that it's not tracked at the beginning, then move around the headset a little bit and then you are fine. You can then have a little guide here. They show you what to do, a quick start guide. Here you can start SteamVR. Here you can do the room setup, but you can also do it in Steam. You can pair devices like the Vive controller, Index controller, or Vive tracker. You can reboot the headset and restart the Pi service. Then you have My Games here. You can directly start any games that are installed. Even Oculus exclusive games like Asgard's Wrath will appear here, and you can just start it from here. That's great. Also, you have help here. Here's the email from the PiMax support, and sometimes they want you to export your logs so that they can help you. You can have a diagnose here. And now this thing here is so heavy. It's so crazy what you can do here. So first, here you can see the current version of the Pi tool and the headset firmware. This is the version I used for this video. And as you can see at this time, this is the latest version. Also for the firmware update, there is no update available. You can choose to run Pi tool at Windows startup. You can hide the taskbar when you click the close button. This one I would deactivate. It needs performance. Just don't do it. And you can turn on the screensaver here. And then HMD. This is crazy. You can do a lot of stuff here. So first you can deactivate Lighthouse, so only the headset itself tracks itself. Then you can choose the color of the front of the PiMax from green, blue, and aquamarine. This one is very interesting. So this setting I have is native at 75 hertz. That means the signal to the two displays is native 4K resolution. And of course, this needs a little bit performance, and it only runs on 75 hertz. So if you want more, if you want a smoother picture, then go for upscaling, and then the 8KX, I would say, switches to a normal PiMax 8K, and that means the signal that comes into the headset is not native 4K, it's half 4K. And then you have 114 hertz, so the picture is smoother, but you don't have native 4K resolution. But the signal is inside the headset upscaled again to 4K because the displays are 4K. And you can choose whatever you want, just play around a little bit. Also, you have the backlight settings. So this is the backlight of the LC display. Crazy, you can play around with the settings until you get a clear picture and a good picture. And then you can play with the IPD offset and vertical offset. And that's crazy. Be careful with that settings. So if you have a smaller IPD than 60 like me, then you might get some problems when you use the Pimax. It feels sometimes like you see cross-eyed with that. And if that happens, you can play around with the IPD offset. So for example, go for minus 1.6 or something like that, and here whatever. It's very mighty. You can play a lot with that stuff. But it's when you play around with the settings, it could be that you don't see the 3D effect anymore. And then that was too much. Go back to the standard settings and try again. As you can see, you can play a lot with this stuff. Motion compensation. I never tried that. And I'm pretty sure this is something to stabilize the motion of the tracking. So I think you can connect a Vive tracker here and place it somewhere, choose it here when it's connected, and it causes that the tracking is better, yeah, that it doesn't move around when you move. But I never tried that. I'm fine with the standard settings. There is absolutely no problem with me. But as you can see, there's a lot of stuff to play around. So as you can see, all the settings here, the next one as well, that means that the Pimax is not a headset for beginners. It's not. So you have to know what you are doing here. So in the game settings, you can go for the common settings, or you can just place a setting for every single game, different setting for every single game. So brain warp here, field of view. You can choose the field of view. So anybody would say, why shouldn't I always go for large? I can tell you, because large needs most performance, of course. And the difference between normal and large is not so much, only a little bit at the edges, but it needs much more performance. So I would recommend stay at normal. And if you have a very weak PC, go on potato. And then you see like toilet paper rolls. The next one is render quality, and if you change the settings, it has a lot of influence on the performance. And it's very important here, SteamVR, go on settings, and then it has something to do with the render resolution. So these both settings, the render quality in PyTool and the render resolution in SteamVR, work together. So you can go for abnormal high resolution if you change this higher and this higher. So I for myself, I leave the render quality at 1 always and play around with the SteamVR render resolution. Of course, the higher the resolution, the better the picture. But you have to check out if your PC can do that. I mean, if you choose like here 150%, or look at this, you can even go for this crazy resolution. And normally I go around 70% or something like that, but I have a powerful PC like RTX 3090 with 9900K. So you really need to play around with these settings to get a good performance. And it even depends on which game you play. So as you can see, you need to play around a lot here. So the next one is fixed forward rendering. That means only the area where you look is rendered in full quality, and the edges are rendered in lower quality. And of course, this causes that you have a lot more performance. So aggressive is most one, of course, and the conservative, the less. Then there's the setting compatible with parallel projections. Leave that disabled. Disable that. Only when something strange happening. So if you don't see 3D effect anymore, or if you see something strange shaking around, or cross-eyed stuff or whatever, then activate that and then restart SteamVR. But normally leave that deactivated, of course. The next one is turn on smart smoothing. I would recommend to turn that on. And that just means if you The native mode, for example, is 75 hertz. If your PC cannot manage to have 75 frames per second. Smart smoothing will do the half of that. I think that's 37, so half of 75, and then fakes every second picture. So at least you finally you will see in the display 75 frames per second again, even though your PC cannot manage that. It fakes every second picture here. Hidden area mask, just leave that enabled all the time as long as you don't see some double picture like you see that here. Leave that enabled. Then there's the setting with compatible with Vive only game. If you need that, just use that. And then you can play around with the colors. Holy shit, you can play a lot of stuff here. Just if you are not satisfied with the picture in the Pimax headset, then just use contrast, brightness, right, green. You can play around with a lot of stuff here, and that's absolutely crazy. So I would recommend, guys, to play around with these settings until you are satisfied. The Pimax is so mighty, the Pi Tool is so mighty that when you use the standard settings, it could look like shit. And when you play around, it could look like the best headset you've ever had. So it's really important to play around with the settings. I also recommend to go to the Pimax forum community. They have a lot of ideas, a lot of settings that they can recommend to have the best vision in the headset. Go there and read a little bit. They have good ideas there. It really depends on the game and on IPD and whatever. It's so mighty, you can do a lot of stuff. I hope that was really interesting for the setup, and the Pi Tool is very, very important. Okay, let's talk about the display. You've seen some through the lens videos now, and I really considered, should I show that or should I not show that? I decided to show that, but you please note, it's very hard to film through the lens. What you've just seen from Half-Life Alyx and Digital Combat Simulator is not really what you see with your own eyes. With my own eyes, it was so awesome. It looked amazing, really. But with the camera, there's also always a little problems, yeah, that you film through the lens, that the angle is not correct or whatever. But however, I showed it to you, and I can tell you in real life, it's even amazing, more amazing. So now I shot some through the lens pictures on the test HMD tool. So let's check out the screen door effect here. These lines that you can see here are from the camera. That's I can't change it. However, if you check here, you will not see any screen door effect. It's nearly invisible, and that's amazing with such a huge field of view and such a huge display. It's totally awesome. And let's check out the next picture here. This is full zoom with my camera. And as you can see, there is nearly no screen door effect. You will not see that with your own eyes. Perhaps a little bit when you check here, but believe me, it's totally great. When you play Digital Combat Simulator, all the little buttons, you can see them, all the text, it's absolutely no problem here. The next thing is the text. As you can see, you can even read the smallest text here. That's also absolutely no problem. These lines here come with for the camera effect. I'm sorry for that. Then the text here, you can see, you can read that very good. The outer edges here are blurry, but this does not happen when you see with your own eyes. Crazy. The colors. So here you have to notice that. Make sure that you play around with the color settings, as I said you in the setup. It's very important. So I choose some settings that are fine for me. I had very good colors. But you should play around with the settings. It's very important so that you can get your individual best color result here. The glare test, the lenses are really good. So there are nearly no God ray or glares. You can see it here a little bit and here, but it's really not much. Believe me, it's fine. That you will not get disturbed by the glare effects. Also, you can see the black levels here. Please note that I choose for me the backlight to 50%. That means everything is a little bit darker, but the black levels are really fine for an LC display. You can choose whatever you want. You can play around with the backlight settings as you wish, but if you change to 100%, of course the black gets a little bit more gray. And here is a sweet spot test. So I try to film through the lens, but this blurry stuff here at the edges, you will not see that with your eyes. Mostly you can see everything very sharp and very clear, and that's a really good thing. If you wear the headset and you think you look cross-eyed, then you have to play around with the IPD offset, as I said in the setup. It's very, very important that you play around with the settings, otherwise you will not be satisfied. Also, if you don't see the 3D effect, or if it's not large enough or whatever, then also play around with the IPD offset. It has much to do with that. Just use the sliders and then check out how the 3D effects look. I played around for one day with all these settings minimum, and I have a good experience, a good result from the colors, the black levels, the 3D effect, and the cross eye effect. And that's really awesome for me. And guys, really, I have to mention that again. If you just buy the Pimax headset and connect it to your PC and start PyTool and start SteamVR, you will likely not be satisfied, okay? The Pimax headset needs to play around with. You have to go to the settings. You have to take one day to check all the settings perfect, to make the colors perfect, the background and all the stuff. You need to play around with the settings. This is very important. Please don't buy the headset if you don't want to do that, okay? That's very, very important. But if you take time for all the settings, then you will get a really good result. You will be amazed, really. So guys, this is the display. For the Hertz, if you choose the native 4K source, then you will have 75 Hertz. For me, this is not a problem. Some people have problems with that. They want more Hertz. Then go to the upscale mode. And then you can, I think, 114 Hertz. And that's great. So guys, that's everything about the display. Let's talk about the field of view. This is a really important point at the Pimax headset. And because the field of view is huge, it's awesome. And if you like big field of views. Then the Pimax headsets, you will love them, especially when you compare them to other headsets. So this is my result of the test HMD tool, and the vertical field of view is 112 and the horizontal field of view is 140. This is normal field of view of Pimax. If you choose large field of view, it's even bigger. But I recommend to play on normal because it's not so much difference, but the you need even more performance then. So this is for my head. You will get totally different results when you use this tool. So be very, very careful. So let's check a comparison between different headsets here. So the outer red line is the field of view of the Pimax in the normal field of view. The outer edge here without the red line, this is Pimax large field of view, okay? And then you will see with the Pimax, you see both mirrors, the left mirror and the right mirror. This is Project Cars. And that's crazy. When you look just straight, you see both mirrors. And this is a really huge difference. With the Valve Index, you see the left mirror and the middle mirror here. You see that? And then comes the other headsets. All the other headsets that have normal view, like the Vive, the Rift, Cosmos, Quest, they are pretty close to each other here with this, that you can only see the half of the middle mirror here. And here is the outer line is the Vive, Rift and Cosmos. And for me, the Reverb G2 is even a little bit smaller here, yeah, but they are all small. So this is a really huge difference. And in my opinion, this is a really big, big, huge advantage of the Pimax headsets. I totally love that. When I played Half-Life Alyx, I was so amazed to see so much of the level, and that's absolutely crazy. It's really crazy. I love it. So, which controllers can you connect to the Pimax 8KX? So, you have to know that the Pimax 8KX is tracked via the Lighthouse system from Valve, and that means that you have to mount the base stations, the minimum two base stations on the wall or on tripods, and then you can connect everything that is compatible to Lighthouse tracking. That means you can use the old Vive ones or Vive controllers, these really bulky things. I call them bones. They work, they are precise, but they are pretty old. So if you have them already or you can get them used very cheap, then it's possible you can use them. Or of course, that's my recommendation, use the Valve Index controllers. They are really awesome. They are new technology. You have full finger tracking and capacitive stuff and thumbsticks, and they are really good. They work with most games, and you can buy them separately from Valve and then connect them via the Pi tool, and that is absolutely no problem. What about game compatibility? So if you want to play SteamVR games, that should be absolutely no problem. There is a setting that's called parallel projections in the Pi tool, and sometimes games have a strange behavior, so it's a little bit distorted or something strange happens. If that happens, just put the switch on and then it will work. So I would say minimum 95 or even more percent of the SteamVR games work without any problems on the Pimax headset, on the Pimax 8KX, and that is really cool. So there is no stretching of the image because of the really big field of view. It's just it just works. It runs in the correct resolution, and the Pimax headset really shows the game as it should, and that's awesome. It's really cool. Yeah, so you can also play via Revive Oculus exclusive games. That also works with the Pimax headset. Only thing that don't work are, of course, Oculus Quest standalone games and PlayStation VR games. That won't work with the Pimax 8KX. Everything else should be no problem. Let's talk about accessories that you can connect to the Pimax 8KX. As I already said, it has the Lighthouse tracking system with these base stations, and that means you can connect, for example, the Vive trackers. So use three Vive trackers, one at your hips and two at your feet, and then you have full body tracking, for example, in VR chat, you know, so you can kick people or stuff, and that's totally cool to have full body tracking. Or you can perhaps use weapons like this, the Hyperblaster. Just screw the Vive tracker on the weapon, and then you can, for example, play with this gun in Arizona sunshines and kill the zombies. It's great. So everything that works with the Lighthouse tracking system will also work with the Pimax 8KX. There are also some modules directly from Pimax. For example, the hand tracking module that you can attach at the bottom of the Pimax with the USB-C slot, and that works really good. I already tried that, and you can play all the games that support hand tracking with it. And the next one is the eye tracking module, this one here, and this causes that the Pimax can see your eyes, and then you can use, for example, dynamic foveated rendering later, or games that support eye tracking. And I already tried this device and I don't like it. The calibration was off, and it didn't really work very good. So wait for some updates for this module, but the hand tracking module really works good. If you want to attach both at the same time, you need an adapter, because the Pimax 8KX doesn't have the USB-C slot behind the face gasket. So use an adapter cable. Let's talk about the tracking, and there is not much to say. It's just perfect, because it supports Lighthouse tracking, and as you know, Lighthouse tracking is the most accurate tracking system for VR. But of course, that means you have to mount two of the base stations in 2 meters height, a diagonal in your play area, and that also means the headset has not much mobility. You have to disassemble the base stations and bring them to your friends if you want to play on other places. So the disadvantage is the mobility, but the advantage is perfect tracking. So the headset itself is tracked via a Lighthouse, and it's just perfect. It's recognizes every millimeter movement, and of course the controllers, if you have the Valve Index oder the Vive controllers, then you have absolutely perfect tracking behind your back, over your head, wherever you want. You can even crouch on the ground and it will be tracked everywhere. So it's great for shooters like Onward or stuff. The tracking is absolutely no problem here. Heat development. So normally Pimax headsets don't get very warm. Of course, a little bit at the front when you touch it and play it a long time, it's warm, but it's not hot, very hot. But when you check out the face gasket and the foam here, look how big that is. Look how big it is. It sits on my completely forehead here. The completely forehead is covered with the foam. So of course the advantage is that it's very comfortable, but the disadvantage, the sweat cannot go everywhere. Your head will never get cooled. So you will sweat under the headset in the summer when it's very hot, or if you play boxing games with a lot of movement. So it will get hot under the headset because of your sweat. However, the hardware doesn't make any problems with overheating. Let's talk about the removable parts of this headset. So of course you can remove the face foam here, the complete face foam, but you can also remove the complete gasket. Just pull it here and here, and then you have it in your hands. So you can just completely replace it if you like. And then you can pull off all of the here of the foam, the foam stuff here, like this one on the side, and this one you can remove, and on the back you can also remove that here. It's just possible. You can remove every part of the foam and then clean it or replace it. You can remove the strap here, and with this little wheels here, you can also remove the complete head strap. That's also possible if you want to replace it to a better one with the Deluxe Audio or whatever. Then for cleaning, so you see the all the gaps here where the face gasket comes. It's very hard to clean because they are really small to reach. So if there's some mud or whatever or sweat, it's a little bit hard to clean here. However, around the lenses is this fabric material, and they will not get any dust or any dirt inside. So that's pretty good. You can also clean the lenses very good, and all the rest you can remove and clean or replace. So that's, I think that's a good thing. Let's talk about IPD. So the Pimax 8KX has mechanical IPD adjustment. You see this little wheel here, and when I spin it, look at this, the lenses go on both sides and other way around here. And as soon as you move this wheel, you can see the current IPD value inside the headset, and the range is from 60 millimeter to 70 millimeter. So if you are in this range, then there's no problem. If you have like 58 or 72, it could be that it gets a little bit unsharp, or it feels as when you look cross-eyed or what. But normally it's just fine. If you have a lower IPD, then use the minimum setting. If you have a higher IPD than the range, then use the highest setting, of course. All in all, it's cool that they implemented that. Let's try the 8KX with some glasses. Look at this one. Pretty normal glasses, and I can try them here. And it's absolutely no problem. It pushes a little bit on the bones of my nose, a little bit, but it's not so uncomfortable. You can just use it normally and use your glasses with that. It's really good here. And if I try a bigger glasses, like these bigger sunglasses, then the problem is that I can try it again. Look at this. Really huge. It fits under the headset here, and I can even use the screw here, but as there is a lot of light leakage here, the glasses reflect the environment behind me or on the side, and that sucks. So you really have to fill the holes here so that the light doesn't come in. So All in all, you can wear the glasses under that, but if you have a same head shape like me, there will be a lot of reflections from the glasses inside. Let's talk about the connectors that the Pimax has. So we have, instead of the old headsets, they need a power adapter. The Pimax 8KX doesn't need a power adapter. It has two USB-C connectors, not USB-C, it's just normal USB connectors, and one display port. And that means no need to connect to power outlet. And then we have the two audio jack, one here and one here. You can use your own headphones, of course. At the bottom, it has one USB-C slot here. And then under the face gasket with the old Pimax headsets, there was another USB-C connector, but this one doesn't have one. So this will... So if you want to use the hand tracking module and the eye tracking module at the same time, then you need to have an adapter cable, but that's not a big problem. I think it comes with the eye tracking module. And then, of course, you can remove the head strap cable here if you like. There is no other connectors of the Pimax 8KX here, but I think it's fine. Let's talk about sound and microphone. So with this headset, there was the integrated sound here, but it only comes to these little slots here on this side and on this side. And I must say the sound is not really good, unfortunately. You cannot compare it to the Valve Index or G2 sound headphones that fly over your ear. They are really awesome. But this one, you can compare it with the Oculus Quest or Quest 2. It also comes through the slots, the sound, and that's not really good. You can buy an additional audio strap, a deluxe audio strap from Pimax that has better integrated headphones that fly over ears. They are a little bit better. So thank you to Pippi from my Discord. He gave me some advice how to improve the sound. So go to your Windows settings and from the sound settings, go for Windows Sonic for headsets. Windows Sonic for headsets. And this can improve the sound a little bit. Also go to enhancements and check Bass Boost, Virtual Sound, and Loudness Equalization. This can improve the sound of the headphones here, but don't expect something very good. They are not really good. On the other side is the microphone that's under the Pimax 8KX, and this sounds pretty good. So here's an example. Welcome back to virtual reality. This is a microphone test of the Pimax 8KX. Let's scream a little bit here and also a little bit more quiet. And let's do some pop, 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 pop sounds. So as you can hear, this is absolutely fine. There is no problem. And you can use that for multiplayer and also for recording videos like me. I will use the Pimax integrated microphone to record my videos. The quality is really good, so there's no problem here. So the sound is bad, but the microphone is good. So what if you don't want to use the lighthouse systems or the base stations? You don't have them, you don't have place, or you don't just don't want it. Just does it work without these lighthouse stations? Yes, it does. So in the Pi tool, there's an option that is called tracking mode, and standard it's choose lighthouse, but you can switch to the 9-axis mode, and then you don't need the base stations anymore. It's just tracked in place, and you can use that when you just play seated games like racing simulations or flight simulations. You don't move around like this in these games, so you don't need the tracking. But the Pimax headset works without the lighthouse stations if you wish. Okay, let's come to a conclusion. You've seen a lot of stuff now. I hope I could give a good overview now. So let's check out the pros and cons again. Pro, of course, the really huge field of view. That's absolutely crazy. The good display, of course. It's a really sharp and really good display, and perfect tracking because they use the lighthouse tracking. On the contrast side, I would say the bad sound with the slots there, and I would say the performance as well. I mean, Yes, it's clear that for such a huge resolution, you need a strong PC. But yeah, when you compare it to the Valve Index can be powered with a 1070 or whatever. But with the Pimax Vision 8KX, don't use a 1070 or 1080. It's just not fun. I mean, I could manage to run a Pimax headset with a 1050 Ti. It works, but it looks like crap. Then you have to lower the settings so much that it looks like crap. So please do yourself a favor and choose a good PC. That's really, really important that you notice, that you keep a note of that. So I would recommend a 2080 and a 6700K minimum for the Pimax Vision 8KX to have fun with that. So, and now let's check out the price. Here comes the price. It's 1,199 euro, and of course this is a lot. And this is only, sorry for that. This is only the headset, yeah? And if you just want to have the full bundle, the Index controllers and the base stations, you pay 1,649 euro. And this is a lot of money. So you have to decide for yourself, is it worth it? It has some disadvantages, the Pimax, but when you compare it to the Valve Index has a smaller field of view and also not such a good display, but it's $600 cheaper. So it depends. It's a really hard decision here. However, what I just wanted to say, if you buy it here, as you can see, you get a little bit better headphones here. So perhaps the sound is not really a disadvantage. These are still not perfect sound, but I think it's okay. Then when you compare it to a less expensive headset, for example, the Reverb G2, it's nearly 1,000 bucks cheaper. But then you have a perfect display, but you have a very small field of view and a tracking with problems. So you should, when you want to buy this headset, then you pay 1,649, but you get everything at best. So the biggest field of view, the sharpest display, and the best tracking. And you have to decide for yourself if this is worth for you 1,649 bucks. It's your decision. I think I would buy it if I didn't already have it. I think I would buy it. Yeah, but it's a strong price, I know that, but it depends on you guys. So if you want to support me to see even more VR reviews, honest VR reviews, then $1 per month via YouTube and Patreon. You can find the link in the description below. That would be awesome. You get behind the scenes videos. So guys, I hope you liked the review. Give me a thumbs up if yes, and see you next time in virtual reality. See ya. Voodoo.de